Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. The Gas Africa Conference, held in Johannesburg this week, provided an overview of the available resources and opportunities in South Africa's oil and gas sector. Natalie Grieve tells us more. Hi, Natalie.
Hi, Chanel.
An accurate quantification of South Africa's offshore oil and gas potential remains elusive, but can you give us a breakdown of the estimated resources?
Well, as you've acknowledged, at this point we don't have an exact figure when it comes to South Africa's offshore oil and gas potential. That'll probably only come out in a few years once exploration becomes a bit more widespread. But the Petroleum Agency of South Africa has put prospective offshore oil reserves at around 21.7 billion barrels of oil and prospective offshore gas deposits at around 62.4 trillion cubic feet. Now, the bulk of these are likely to lie off the west coast, where we have already seen some exploration drilling.
And what about the onshore potential?
Well, there's been a surge in interest around onshore oil and gas exploration in recent years, and this has largely been driven by rumours of a massive shale gas deposit in the centre of the country. Now, again, while this deposit has yet to be confirmed, the Petroleum Agency of South Africa puts it at around 40 trillion cubic feet of recoverable resources. Now, while this sounds like quite a big figure, it's actually far below prior estimates by other organisations, which have been as high as around 390 trillion cubic feet.
During the conference, the South African Oil and Gas Alliance also urged South Africa to develop its gas distribution network ahead of local reserves of offshore liquefied natural gas becoming available. Can you elaborate on this?
Well, the Alliance is arguing that South Africa shouldn't wait for the existence of these offshore finds to be confirmed, that we should already start importing liquefied natural gas, or LNG, from countries in West and Central Africa and elsewhere in the world, and so simultaneously developing the associated distribution infrastructure so that if and when these offshore and onshore gas deposits are found, that the infrastructure to distribute them already exists in the country. They've said that exploration needs to yield at least 10 trillion cubic feet of resources that can be extracted at a commercially viable level in order to compete with the imported gas supplies and to support a South African natural gas value chain. Now, if we do find deposits in the country that can be extracted at a commercially viable level, we could see the creation of a domestic natural gas industry within the next 7 to 10 years.
Thank you. That's the Second Take show for this week. Thank you for watching, and join us again next time for more news analysis.